morning students, how are you all? You all are fine? Okay, thank you. Have you completed yesterday's homework? Yes, I think you all are understanding what I am teaching to you. Today we will learn the next heading, the traditional approach. Already we have learned the accounting equation approach. There are two approaches in accounting. Okay, the second one is traditional approach. Traditionally they follow this approach only. Okay, from time being, from the beginning of the accounting, they are following this traditional approach. This is what we are going to start. This is the one, it is followed by everyone all over the world. Okay, this traditional approach. Here only we follow the double entry bookkeeping system. Okay, double entry bookkeeping system is followed in this approach. What is double entry bookkeeping system? There are two aspects for each and every transactions, isn't it? So for each and every transaction there are two aspects. One is debit, the other is credit, isn't it? So for this for the purpose of recording this one in the transactions, we need to learn the classification of accounts. There we learned in the accounting equation approach, there are that totally mainly three accounts there we learned, isn't it? First one, accounting equation is equal, what is what? Assets is equal to liabilities plus capital, isn't it? Then another income and expenditure also affect this capital. So totally five accounts we learned in accounting equation approach, isn't it? Assets account, then the capital account, then liabilities account, then the expenses that affects the capital and the income that affects the capital. So the final equation is assets is equal to capital, sorry, liabilities plus capital minus expenses plus income. So it affects five accounts together, isn't it? Here we will have the main classification is two. One is personal account and impersonal account. Personal, and the second is impersonal. Understand? Then personal account is again divided into natural person, then artificial person, then representative personal, then impersonal, again real account and nominal account. Okay, then real account again divided into two, that is tangible and intangible. I will discuss everything in detail. Okay, I will explain everything in detail to you. First one, personal accounts. Okay, the main heading, personal accounts. What are personal accounts? You know, the account relating to persons, that is called personal account, isn't it? Here it is again divided into three: natural person's account, natural personal account, then artificial person's account, representative person's account. Okay, so first one, natural personal account. Natural person's account. Natural person, we can say the human beings. Who are the natural persons? They are the human beings. Human beings means all the men and women, isn't it? That maybe example we can say. Then Shalini's account. Shalini's account. Then a person, we can say mothers account. Yep, men and women, isn't it? So it is Shalini's account, mother's account, that is natural person's account. Then the second one, many name, no, all the names of a man or woman, all these will come under natural person's account. Then the next one, artificial person's account. Here they will not create a person. Okay, artificial person's account, it means that not other than the human beings. Okay, any that we can say maybe an institution or a company. We study, you will study in commerce that joint stock companies, that is an artificial person, because it is created by man, but it is created as a person under law. Okay, any joint stock company, any institution, that means it is recognized by law as a person. That is why it is called artificial person. Understand? That all the business concern, okay, sole proprietorship concern, all partnership concern, then company, then any other big business concerns, okay, everything will come under this artificial person. Even bank also will come under this artificial person. Okay, then the third one is representative personal account. Okay, representative personal account. Why it is called a representative person's account? Here, this represent a person, these accounts. Okay, representative personal account represents a person. For example, that outstanding salary. Outstanding salary. Because outstanding, you know, that salary due, we need to pay to others. So, salary is due to whom? A person. We need to pay that one to a person. That is why it is considered as representative personal account. That represents a person. This account represents a person. Outstanding salary, then any prepaid expense, outstanding expense, then income, that accrued income or not received, and the income received in advance. All these will come under this representative personal accounts. Have you understood now? That personal accounts. Okay. Main classification, personal and impersonal. Under personal, natural person, then artificial person, representative personal account. These three we have learned. Now we will learn the impersonal accounts. Impersonal accounts. This impersonal accounts not related to human beings, not related to person. Okay. So this account will not affect the personal accounts. So this one again divided into two. One is tangible, no, impersonal account is again divided into real account and nominal account. Okay, real account and nominal account. This real account again divided into two. The first one is tangible. Real account means we can say the asset account. Tangible asset, intangible asset. Okay, here tangible real account, intangible real account. This we will see now. What is tangible real account? So first, what is the real account? That is, it includes all the tangible real account and the all the intangible real account. First, we should know what is the asset. First, we have heard that one asset, isn't it? All the properties or possessions. That what we possess, isn't it? The properties and possessions, what we have as an asset, they are called the assets or the real accounts. Okay. Now, this properties and possessions that can be seen and touched. They are called tangible real assets. What are tangible real assets? That we can see and touch. For example, furniture. Furniture can be seen and touched, isn't it? Furniture we can see and we can touch and see, isn't it? So it is having some physical existence. It has physical existence. It exists. We can physically, it is physically available. We can touch, we can see what it is. But that is called tangible assets. All those accounts, that assets are tangible, come under this tangible real account. Okay, example, we can say example, this furniture, then land, all the fixed assets. Land, we can see, isn't it? Building, then furniture, then the machineries, then office equipments, computer, motor vehicle, fax machine, all that we use in the office. Then motor vehicle, car. All these are the tangible assets. Examples of tangible assets. They have physical existence. Okay. Then the next one is intangible real account. Opposite of tangible real account. Okay. What is intangible real account? This is also that properties and possessions only, but cannot be seen and touched. Okay? We cannot see them and we cannot touch them. Understand? They are called intangible. Okay, intangible assets. They do not have physical existence. We cannot see them, we cannot touch them, and it doesn't take any physical posture. We cannot see them. Okay, no physical existence, that one. So here, what the examples we can say for this intangible assets? That first one we can say the goodwill. Goodwill, you know, that name of that company. By running for many years, it might have received a good name among the people in the public. It has got a good name, that is called goodwill. Then copyrights. Copyrights, if we write a book related to book, if you write a book, that to take copies of that book, we have got a copyright. Okay, so in the publishers, if in any book you can see in the front page copyright, one symbol will be there, C round will be there. So that is reserved for some people. Maybe the author or any publisher will have that right to copy that books. Okay, then patent rights, simply they will say patents. What is this one? Regarding new inventions or discovery of a product or whatever it is. Okay, if you invented something, you will get one right, that is called patent right. So if anyone wants to produce that particular product, they have to give a lump sum to you to produce that you have invented or you have discovered. Okay, related to that one, if they want to do any extra thing, they need to produce related your product, then they have to give a lump sum, that is called patent right. No one can copy that one. They cannot say that they have invented that one. Okay, that right is called patent right. Okay, all these, can we see this one with our eyes? No, there is no physical existence, we cannot see and we cannot touch. They are the intangible assets. Okay, now real account we have understood. Now the second one, nominal accounts. Nominal accounts. all these nominal accounts just related to expenses, losses, income, gains. Only this many that occur in the business, they will come under nominal accounts. Okay, all the accounts related to expenses, losses, incomes, and gains are called nominal accounts. Okay, what are the expenses that will come in a business house? First one, they have to pay the salary, isn't it? Then workers, they will pay wages. Then any that office expenses, to run the office expenses, they will buy pen, pencil, stationery, isn't it? Then any related to selling, any expenses related to selling, they are called selling expenses. Maybe packing charges, carriage outward. Okay, then losses, bad debts. Some debtors may not return their amount to us. They may not pay back the debts due to them. So that will may be a loss. Then depreciation. We will write off a percentage of asset each year. That is called depreciation. All these loss. Then income. Any rent receivable. We need to receive some rent. Or any commission that should be received. Okay, all these are the income. Any gain, any discount we have received from our creditors. Okay, discount received. All these are the things that we should enter in the nominal account. All these related to nominal accounts. Okay, since these are related to revenue items. Okay, to run the business, every year, every month, we may pay this expenses. Often we pay, that is recurring in nature. So we can say revenue expenditure, revenue income. So where this will be entered? In the trading and profit and loss account. Trading and profit and loss account, you will learn later. Okay, revenue items, capital items, the opposite one, that you will learn in one chapter. Okay, 9th, 8th, 10th chapters will be coming there. Okay, there you will learn. Now, whether it is nominal, you have to understand. To prepare the journal entry, all these you should know. Because very important is to differentiate between that, whether it is a debit or a credit. Okay, so for that only we are learning all these accounts. Three accounts are there. Personal account, then not two accounts. Mainly they will divide it into three. Okay, personal account, real account and nominal account. Okay, the personal account, then impersonal divided into three, isn't it? Two, real account, nominal account. So totally how many accounts we have? Three accounts, main accounts. First one, personal. They will not ask whether impersonal. No, personal, real, nominal. Now, we will learn the rules. Rules related to account, that debit and credit. Okay, these rules are called as golden rules of accounting. Golden rules of accounting. Assembly rules of accounting. Okay, golden rules of accounting. Or golden rules of assembly rules of double entry system of bookkeeping. In any way they can ask. Okay, rules of accounting. How many accounts we have learned now? Three accounts, isn't it? First one, personal. Then the next one, real account. The third one, nominal account. This is the fundamental thing, that rule we should know. Okay. So these are the accounts. then what should be debited and what should be credited in personal account? What should be debited? Okay, debit the receiver. Debit the receiver. Credit the giver. Credit the giver. The person, isn't it? One who receive anything, we have to debit. If a person gives something, we should credit his account. Okay. Debit the receiver, credit we will write here. Credit the giver. Okay, real account, what should be debited and what should be credited? Debit what comes in. What debit what comes in. Here, real account consists of assets, isn't it? Regarding asset, here it is person. So, the receiver we have debited, giver we have credited. Here you see, here the asset, any asset comes in, we should debit. So, what is the opposite? Credit what goes out. Okay? Credit what goes out. Whatever goes out from the organization, we have to credit. What is coming inside, we should debit. Understood? This is the main rules that you should know. Okay, then for the nominal accounts, we know nominal accounts consist of four things, isn't it? Expenses, losses, income, gain. So, debit the first two. Debit all expenses and losses. Expenses and losses. Then, credit all incomes and gains. Incomes and gains, that's all. Okay, whenever, wherever we ask the rules of accounting, you must know. Wherever you go, this is the fundamental rule. Okay, golden rules of accounting. What should be debited? Only three accounts in the traditional approach. This is what we will start. Okay, that accounting equation is not followed by all the organizations. That is one equation that will not work out. But throughout the world, what is now used is this traditional approach. For that one only, that all the process of accounting we studied, isn't it? That identifying, measuring, summarizing, all these we have learned, all these done on the basis of this traditional approach. Okay, for that traditional approach only, they are dividing the accounts into three, mainly two, personal and impersonal. Now, that person is again divided into three, we have studied. That is the main one, personal account. Then, the second one, impersonal, that is divided into two, real account and nominal account. Real account related to asset, nominal account related to all the expense, loss, income and gain. Okay, persons related to persons, personal account. So, we should debit the receiver and credit the giver. Then, in a real account, what should be debited? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. That's all. Okay, now we have learned the rules of accounting or the golden rules of accounting. Often they will ask every time. Often we cannot say every time they ask this question. Very rare only they may not ask. So you can expect 2 mark or 3 mark for this one. Understand? 2 mark or 3 mark. Here also it is the question answer of the 2 mark question, 8th one. Okay, 2 mark question, 8th one. And they have asked the another one question, 2 mark, 7th one. What are the rules for nominal account? What should be debited and what should be credited? So, you should learn. Okay. Now, one illustration is given. We should identify in which account we have to enter. Okay. Whether, if I say one account, whether it is personal account, real account or nominal account, you should say. Okay. Asset, any asset you have to write real account. or this one, expense, loss, income, gain. You have to write normal account. Persons, what are the person? Maybe any name of the persons or any institution, company's name or firm's name or any bank, all will come under personal account. In this one, you should remember one more thing. The investment made by the proprietor, that is called capital, isn't it? That is also related to a person. So it will come under personal account. And any amount withdrawn by the proprietor, that is drawings, that is also related to the person, that means the owner. So that also will come under personal account. Okay, so now I will ask you, and in the illustration, there is one illustration they have given that I will show to you. Okay, see, they have given this. Classify the following into personal, real and nominal accounts. Capital, I told you, isn't it? Capital is related to the investment made by the proprietor. So it is related to a person. So it will come under personal account. Carriage inward. What is this one? That amount payable. Or you want me to explain everything in the notebook? Okay, I will explain in the notebook what it is. Okay, then only you will understand in future. Capital. I will explain, okay? Just in a few sentences I will explain, then only you will understand. We know already, isn't it? Amount invested by the owner or proprietor. So it is related to personal account. Isn't related to person, so personal account. It will ask whether it is personal account, real account or non-real account. Next one, I will say carriage inward. Okay, carriage inward. We have never heard these words, that's why I am explaining. Okay, carriage inward means inward, that means carriage, you know, isn't it? For to carry the luggage. Here what is not the luggage of any person. Here the products will be carried into the factory or in the business organization. So any goods we have purchased for the purpose of resale, that will be brought in a truck or any other vehicle. The charge that we pay for this carriage only is called carriage inward. It is an expense. Okay, carriage inward, so that is nominal account. Okay, nominal account. Then that B, building. Building, you know, it is as an asset, isn't it? So asset, so which account it is? Real account. That is easy to find out, isn't it? Building. C, we have learnt. Then cash. Cash also an asset, isn't it? So it is real account. Then commission received, clearly given, I have told you already, any that income received, so it is nominal account, income, isn't it, nominal account. Then bank, any one organization, isn't it, so it is that what it is, artificial person, isn't it, so it is personal account. Personal account. Purchases. Purchases, it is related to purchases. It is real account. It is not an asset, but we purchase something come inside, isn't it? So we have to treat this account as real account only, but they have given us nominal. So in that way they have concluded as an expense. We spend money on this one. Okay, that we can write as either real also or nominal. but it will not come like nominal account. Okay, real only it will be correct. Real account. They have given us nominal. It is wrong. Because that is coming in. Purchases means what? We are purchasing goods. Isn't it? Something coming inside. So it will come under real. They have taken as that expense. We are spending something to purchase the goods. Okay? This one only rules will be correct. For real account, debit what comes in. Okay, we will debit the purchases. So it is better to think like real account. Then Chandru. Chandru, very clear. It is a person, isn't it? He is a person, so it is personal account. Then outstanding wages. I explained, isn't it? This one, outstanding expense is the that personal account. Which account it is? It will come under personal account, representative personal account, because this wages is given. Due to a person, so it will come under personal account. Okay, they may ask separately outstanding wages. They may give some accounts to choose. Okay, representative personal account, then artificial person's account, or by seeing the wages they may ask nominal account. So you must say what it is. It is representative personal account. So, main heading, personal account. Either the question is, classify the following into personal, real or nominal. So, you have to say that whether either it is personal or real or nominal. Understand? Okay. Journal entries we will learn tomorrow's class. Okay. So, today I will mark and give you the question answers. Okay, under the traditional approach, how are personal accounts classified? Okay, the very short answer, sixth question. How are personal accounts classified? You can write this one from here till here, or one by one you can write. Okay, here not natural person's account, number B artificial person's account, number C representative personal account, like that, one down the other you can write and show. Okay, 2 marks only, or you can write one sentence also. Okay, that you learn. Then this one, state the accounting rule for nominal account in the next page. Page number I am not telling because the page number is different in your book. Okay, nominal account, this one you have to mark. Nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gains, that you have to mark. Then give the golden rules of double entry system of accounting. Okay, then all the three fully. Okay, these three fully you have to mark. Then what is real account? Because very, very important, that you say they have asked many questions from this one. Real account. What is real account? You have to write here. Again, you can write real accounts are again divided into tangible real account. Can be touched and seen. Okay. One sentence you can write from this real account. Up to here you mark. Simply you can study. Only one sentence on one heading, this one and this one. I think we have marked everything, isn't it? Then preparing journal entries, we will see tomorrow. Then see this one. What are the three different types of personal accounts? Third question. What are the three different types of personal accounts? This one. Three. Since 3 mark question, you have to write one sentence. So fully you have to learn. Okay. Okay, that's all. We will mark that remaining questions later. Okay, students. Thank you, students. You learn well and be ready to start the problems tomorrow. Okay, thank you very much.